Hi everyone. In the immunology subject, we are going to learn about autoimmunity. Normally, immune system does not react to self antigen due to the protective mechanism of self tolerance that we are having. However, if there is a failure, then immune system reacts and produces an inappropriate responses to self antigens, and this response is going to be termed as autoimmunity. So autoimmunity is a failure of an organism in recognizing its own constituent part as non-self, which allows an immune response against its own cells and tissues is going to be called as autoimmunity. Autoimmune reactions can cause serious damage to cells, organs or tissues, which can be fatal at some times also. Okay, and the tissues or cellular damage could be caused by either the autoantibody or by the T cells. Generally, the disorders of an immune system can be of immunodeficiency, that means where the immune system responds too little. In the same manner, hypersensitivity, where we have discussed about this hypersensitivity in detail in another part, go through it. Where in the hypersensitivity, the immune system is going to react too much. Okay, then coming to the autoimmunity, it is going to be of the immune system is misdirected. It is going to be misdirected. So as I told you, it is a failure of an organism in recognizing its own constituent parts as non-self, which allows an immune response against its own cells and tissues. Any disease that results from such an abrupt immune response is going to be called as autoimmune disease. So autoimmunity basically means immunity to self, a condition that occurs when the immune system mistakenly attacks and destroys the healthy body tissues. Okay, so that's how this autoimmunity can also be called as autoallergy. That name was autoallergy has been suggested, but the term autoimmunity is being widely used. Okay, then coming to the causes of autoimmunity, autoimmunity can be brought about by various factors or variety of factors, and those different factors may contribute differently to different diseases. So let's begin with the first one. Sudden specific or self antigens or present in closed system are not accessible to the immune system, and those are being called as hidden antigen. What we call them as hidden antigens or sequestered antigens. They are being called as hidden antigens or sequestered antigens. Example, the lens protein of the eye is enclosed in its capsule, and immunological tolerance against this antigen is not established during fetal life. Following cataract surgery or penetrating injury, when it leaks out into the, this means the lens protein leaks out into the blood circulation, it may induce an immune response causing damage to the lens of the other eye. Then moving to the next, another example of the same certain self antigens, is the best example is spermatozoa. A spermatozoa develop only with puberty, that we know. The tolerance is not established during the fetal life again. So when the sperms are leaked into the blood circulation, it initiates immune response that leads to the sterility. Okay, so these are the best examples where the self antigens that are enclosed in some systems are going to be acting as a hidden antigens or sequestered antigens, are also responsible of causing this autoimmunity. Then moving to the second type, cells or tissues may undergo antigenic alteration because of physical, chemical or biological influences. Such altered antigens are called as neoantigens. For example, physical means when they are going to be exposed to irradiation, photosensitivity or cold allergy. Then chemical means some sort of a drugs. And coming to the biological means some sort of viral infections or bacterial enzymes. So because of all these influences, such if you are having any alterations in the thing, then we call them as neoantigens. We call them as neoantigens, which may induce an immune response. Then moving to the third, autoimmunity may result to the cross-reacting organ-specific foreign antigens. Example, we can take it as a neurological complications following anti-rabic immunization in humans. With neutral vaccine prepared from the infected sheep brain, or which are going to be inactivated by the phenol. When this anti-rabic vaccine is injected, then obviously antibodies are produced against a sheep brain antigens that may damage nervous tissue of humans. So that's how this cross-reacting organ-specific is also going to cause the autoimmunity. Then moving to the antigenic mimicry between the infecting microorganisms and self-antigen may cause autoimmunity. Example, our joint membranes and the mycobacterium tuberculosis are going to have the same mimicry nature, and some sort of arthritogenic shigella and flexinaria and HeLa cells B27 are also going to have the mimicry nature. That is, it can imitate the things, and Coxsackie B virus and mycocardium. So both are having the antigenic mimicry between those two. Okay, that is self antigens and the infecting organisms. Then polyclonal B cell activation by some sort of a chemicals like 2-mercaptoethanol, or by bacterial products like lipopolysaccharides, or by some enzymes like trypsin and some antibiotics like nystatin, and infections with bacteria like mycoplasma, viruses and parasite may result in autoimmunity. So these are the several causes by which we are going to have this autoimmunity development. And then even the breakdown of immunological hemostasis may lead to the cessation of the tolerance and emergence of forbidden clones of immunocompetent cells capable of mounting immune response against self antigens. And even increased helper T cells activity and decreased suppressor T cells activity may lead to the autoimmunity. So these are all the different types or different causes by which we are going to have the autoimmunity. Then because of this autoimmunity, you are going to have the some sort of a diseases, and those are being called as autoimmune diseases. So any disease that results from such an aberrant immune response is termed as an autoimmune disease. And this autoimmune reaction can cause serious damage to the cells, organs or tissues, which can sometimes be fatal at many times. And the tissues or cellular damage could be caused by mainly by antibodies or T cells. Okay. Then the autoimmune diseases may be organic specific or systemic. That means they may be restricted to some organs, or their whole system is going to be damaged. So that's how the autoimmune diseases may be of your organic specific or systemic diseases. So let's see the first one, organic specific autoimmune diseases. In an organ specific autoimmune disease, the immune response is directed to a target antigen unique to a single organ or gland. Obviously, if it is specific to a single organ or gland, then we call it as organ specific. So that the manifestations are largely limited to that organ. Okay, and the cells of the largest organ may be damaged directly by humoral or cell mediated mechanism. And alternatively, the antibodies may overstimulate or block the normal functioning of the target organs. So here are the some of the examples of the autoimmune diseases and what are the self antigen that are going to act and what is the result of it. So let's see. So autoimmune hemolytic anemia, where the self antigen is RBC membrane proteins and the immune response is autoantibodies. Then the Graves disease, thyroid stimulating hormone receptor, generally if it is going to be more production, the hormones itself is going to act as a feedback inhibition in a normal conditions. But in the Graves disease, it is going to be produced and causes the hyperthyroidism, and that is also because of the autoimmunity. Then the next one is the insulin dependent diabetes mellitus, and where the pancreatic beta cells are acting as a self antigen, and here it is a causing of autoantibodies as well as the delayed type hypersensitivity cells, T delayed type hypersensitivity cells. And then mesothelioma gravis, and the self antigen is a acetylcholine receptor and autoimmune. And spontaneous fertility, the sperm is the main one, and the autoantibodies. So here is the mesothelioma gravis, where the mechanism, this anti-acetylcholine antibodies prevents the muscles from responding to the neutral, that is our neural impulse. So obviously what happens, you are going to you can't sense it, okay? So that's how this mesothelioma gravis mechanism disease is going to occur. Then Graves disease, so these are the symptoms of bulge, thyroid, all the things which is a picture of Graves disease showing, okay? So these are the two best examples of organ specific, where the specific organs are going to be targeted. Then moving to the systemic autoimmune disease. In systemic autoimmune diseases, the response is directed towards a broad range of target antigens and involves several organs and a broad range of tissues also. Okay, so along with the organs, tissues, overall system is going to be damaged. So that's how we call this as systemic autoimmune diseases. Okay, so tissue damage is widespread, both from cell mediated immune response and from direct cellular damage caused by autoantibodies or by accumulation of immune complexes. So here are the some examples of autoimmune diseases causing the systemic disease. So multiple sclerosis, okay, so here you can see multiple sclerosis, where the central nervous system and the brain and spinal cord is going to have a myelin sheath. And this, in multiple sclerosis, what is happening is this sheath is going to be getting inflammated, and that is going to destroy the scarring of this membrane around this axon, and that's how you are going to get the multiple sclerosis disease. And this here you can see the what we call it a rheumatoid arthritis, and here is a systemic lupus erythematosus, a butterfly shape autoimmune disorder that you can see. Okay, so these are the things. Multiple sclerosis, where the self antigen is brain and the immune responding cells are going to be TDTH cells, T cells, autoantibodies and immune complexes. Then coming to the rheumatoid arthritis, the connective tissues and the IgG immunoglobulins are mainly acting as self antigens in damaging this rheumatoid things. And then autoantibodies and the immune complexes are involved in this immune response. Then scleroderma, the nuclei, heart, lungs, kidney, gastrointestinal tract, all are going to act as self antigen, and the autoantibodies are involved in damage. Then systemic lupus erythematosus, the DNA, nucleoprotein, RBC and platelet membranes are mainly involved, and the immune response is because of these autoantibodies and immune complexes. So these are the some of the systemic autoimmune diseases. Then moving to the diagnosis, then how can we diagnose whether the autoimmunity disorder is there or not? So the serum autoantibodies frequently provided valuable diagnostic markers, isn't it? The most useful routine tests are CFT, that is complement fixation test, then we had agglutination test, immunofluorescence test, and even enzyme immunoassay like ELISA, all the thing, and radioimmunoassay. So these are the tests which are oftenly useful as a routine test to identify this autoimmunity disorder. And the test will also prove of value in screen for people at risk and general population. Then coming to the treatment, so how can we treat these autoimmune disorders and to control the autoimmune diseases? Here are the list. In case of organ specific disease, replacement therapy is usually adequate. Example, thyroxin in primary myxoedema, vitamin B12 in pernicious anemia, and so forth. But in SLE and immune complex nephritis, steroids often in high doses help to suppress the inflammatory lesions, okay, that is systemic lupus disease. So where you are going to have the high doses of steroids, then immune suppressive drugs such as azithromycin, cyclophosphamide, methyl tricaxate and cyclosporine are used to inhibit the synthesis of autoantibodies. And a long treatment with anti-lymphocyte serum is also the best treatment method. And even the plasma exchange to lower the ratio of immune complex deposition, because more the deposition of autoimmune complexes, more the damage will be there for the tissues and organs. So plasma exchange is also going to remove the excess of the deposition of these immune complexes. And in the disease of rheumatoid arthritis, apart from steroids, anti-inflammatory drugs are also widely used. And a potential valuable approach is switching off primary, that is primary B cells, by presenting Haptin linked to thymus independent carrier like the copolymer D-glutamic and D-lysine, or isologous IgG, particularly with high cortisone doses. So this can also be used by switching off the primary B cells by presenting the Haptins by using these copolymer drugs. Okay, so that's how in the treatment of autoimmune diseases, these methods can be followed. So in the autoimmunity topic, we had gone through the definition of autoimmunity, then what are the causes of autoimmunity, then what are the different types of autoimmune disorders, that is or diseases. We had organ specific, and then we had the systemic, isn't it? Then we had gone to the diagnostic methods, and finally we had gone with the treatment of autoimmune diseases. So this is all about the autoimmunity, which is also called as autoallergy. Thank you.